Alright, here we go. Got some Johnny Cash going. Love it. Alright, right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the steaks I got. I got the little one. Alright. And I got my sirloin steak. Alright. Since I don't have any Tupperware because I only take the Tupperware from Chinese food when people order it, I've used my only one for my peppers, onions, so forth, which is filtered bread. Trust me, it smells great. It was great when you saute them too. Alright. Got my Ziploc bag in here. Alright. First things first, get into this meat. Alright, just cutting along the edge there. Just gonna peel it back. And boom, expose that nice meat. Alright. I'm gonna wash it first, like you're supposed to with all the other meat that you get. Now, first off, disposal. Alright. For disposal wise, what I do is I take one of the bags from the commissary after I'm done using it, and I use it as my trash. And I walk it right up to the trash pit. Done. Alright. So I'm gonna go and I'm gonna wash the steak. Trash.
I'm here still.
Can you see me?
There you go.
Good.
Alright. Yeah, okay.
See, what I'm doing here is I take the meat and, as funny as it sounds, squeeze it, tug it, beat it. Sorry guys, just slapped my meat over on the side there. Alright. I mean, this is a nice cut. Alright, usually when I get steak from there, there's a little bit of fat on the sides, and I just take my knife and fat off. But to be quite honest, there's not much fat going on here. You know, it's a nice steak. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kind of spread it apart so it gets a little bigger. Now, on top of that, when I put it into a marinade, the marinade's gonna suck into it a lot quicker and a lot easier. Take it. And it goes right into the bag. Done. Alright. Next piece. Same thing. Cut it down. Open it up. Take it up. Trash. And wash it.
I guess you listen to me beat my meat again.
This one's not going to be for the faint of heart. If you don't like meat, you don't like looking at raw meat, then you better turn this off or turn away. You're probably not even watching anyway, so I don't give two shits. It's too damn long. But, take a look at this. See how that's all opened up like that? Yeah. That's what you want. So now this is going to go right into the marinade. Got a little fat here. No big deal. I'm going to rinse my hand off. Big fan of Bon Jovi. Love the man's work. Just gonna clean up a little bit here. Got a little bit of blood stains every here and there. Alright, now all I'm gonna do is take my knife, hand in knife, which is cleaned after I did the peppers and onions. Thoroughly washed. Now I'm just gonna cut this fat off. Now, the major principle of this is not to watch me cook or prepare cooking, but more or less to sit here and say, you know what, I live in a barracks and I need to spend all this money on going out and buying fast food and becoming a fat ass, so my PRT, I fail it miserably. No. What I'm trying to do here is to show you how to have a good, clean living, eat right, and all you're doing is spending a hell of a lot less than going to Burger King every day. And spending $6-$7 on a meal, which, you know, there's actually been a study done at, like, say, McDonald's, where they took a bunch of McDonald's fries, put them underground for 4 years in a jar, and when they dug them back up, they looked the exact same way. Now, what they did was they took in potatoes, cut them up into fries, deep fried them, and then put them into a jar, put them underground for about, I don't know, I think it was like 4 months. And even as after 4 months, they're already rotting green and disgusting and nasty. So what does it say about McDonald's fries? Fast food fries in general. Just stick away from fast food, please. I tried to, and I think it would be a healthier America if you didn't. You know, go there and eat all that stuff. It's nasty. I mean, if you want to become a fat ass and get all that shit, be my guest, you know. Keynote 2, I'd like to point out, if you're instead of eating red meat like I am, I don't have access to buffalo, but if you have buffalo or bison that are in your area that you can get, please, by all means, get it. I believe it's like 98% meat all the time. It's really high in protein, less in fat content, and it's just really lean. A little gamey, but it's still a really good burger if you even get a burger steak. Hell, this even liver is great from bison. I love eating bison liver. Take about 2 onions, dice it up, saute those onions, and then while those onions start tang, throw the liver right on top of it, sear it on the onions, and then you sear it on the other side, and then throw it into its own pan to cook. And make sure there's lots of Crisco or something like that. And maybe a little higher fat content from that way, but still, liver is really good for you. I hate to put it that way, guys. And just ask Desiree knows, I love liver. Her daddy got me into it. God bless that man. But anyway, I'm all done here with cutting this meat up. Now here comes the fun part. I'm gonna get people's reactions outside too as I'm cooking this, so everyone can see what it actually smells like. Cause it's gonna be random people walking through a smoke pit while I'm having cigarettes, and then go, "Ooh, what's that smell? It smells so good. Where's mine? Where's mine?" Well, you're not gonna get any, but let's see how awesome it is. Now I'm taking the smokehouse maple, all right, seasoning. I'm gonna put some in here just to give it that extra little zing. This what gives it the smell. If you can smell this, it really does smell like a maple scent, like a maple wood. Now mind you, we have 2 steaks in here, so each time I shook that thing, it was probably about a teaspoon coming out. Alright. Now, for this one, what we're going to do, we're going to use our Kansas City style. So crack this bad boy open. And I'm just going to start dumping it. What does that taste like? A little bit of maple in there, too. Alright. I'm just going to put a little bit in there just to give it that sweet taste. Alright. Put a little bit of our Memphis in there. Alright, the reason why the Memphis is in there because it has the brown sugar in it. That's what makes it a Memphis, I guess. I don't know. But this stuff is sweet. I made chicken the other day with this stuff. This is a combination of Jack Daniel's, Memphis, and this honey barbecue sauce. People were going apeshit over it, and I loved it. Alright, going to put a little bit more brown sugar. Alright, this one's from Kraft. This one, seriously, 99 cents. Alright, I'll dump all of it in there if I want to, but I don't give two shits because, like I said, it's a dollar. Alright, but brown sugar. Alright, a little bit of that in there. Sum 41 with me. No. Don't know what that is. No. 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 What's with all Sum 41? Where the fuck did all this come from? Ooh, what the hell? Why did I skip that? Alright. Sorry, guys. Alright. My favorite, Jack Daniel sauce. Alright. Jack Daniel burgers are really great, especially if you go out and you put the Jack Daniel, you marinate the meat, like your hamburgers, and Jack Daniel sauce. And then you marinate them, and as it's in there, you put the Jack Daniel sauce on top of it so it's cooking with it. And then you put a little extra on the side and add a little bit of actual Jack Daniels to it. It makes it really sweet. And oh my god, best burger I ever had in my life. Thank you, Keys, for inviting me to that barbecue a year ago. It was great. And then a little bit of honey mustard sauce here. Not honey mustard sauce, just add that little bit of the sweet zing to it, too. Alright, so we have all of our stuff in there. Alright, got a decent amount, you can see. Alright. Now, the reason why I put so much barbecue sauce in here is that, yes, it's going to marinate in it. Now, on top of that, when it's sitting out on the grill, I'll take it, and I'll squeeze some of it out, and I'll throw it all on top of it. And I'll sit there and let it marinate with that. And I'll marinate the cook with it and on top of it. And try and push it all in and get it all soaking in. So everything goes in. everything gets sucked in. Alright. Here you go. Two steaks. Ready to sit overnight. Tomorrow's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be eating steak. I was thinking about tonight maybe making a pepper steak and such, but I don't know. Pepper steak? It seems like a lot of time. I might just actually go out and make the hot dogs and just call it a night. I was thinking about marinating the chicken too while I was at it, but even so, if I marinate the chicken, then that's 10 of them I gotta open up and throw into a bag, and I wanna try and make different things out of it. Anyway, any questions, comments, concerns? Didn't think so. I'm not asking for your opinion. This has been Nate Mustang, and you'll get me on the next time when we ask you to cook the shit. Shut up.